That's what happens. People you like turn you down.
I don't know if they'd turn me down. We never get that far. I just sort of preempt any turning down by never putting myself in that position.
You're an idiot. But he said it almost fondly. There was no hint of any kind of pity or suspicion in his eyes, and he was sitting there at knee level, practically staring into the space where my leg should be.
Yes, I am. A complete Wally. It would just have been horrible to really like you and for you to know it, so it would be all unrequited and having you try to avoid me and everything.
Jake glanced down at Gareth, who was starting to make coming round noises. Yes, you're clearly very lovable, and anyone who says differently is just asking to be taken out with the Plaster of Paris table centrepiece.
He tried to kiss me. I didn't even want him to come in. He just barged past me.
I thought you liked me.
Gareth spoke, his voice a little muffled from being face down on the rug.
I thought we had a connection.
Nope. And whatever you thought, it didn't give you the right to come waltzing in here and trying to kiss me. And you lied to me about why you were in Heavington, so not a level playing field, Gareth.
You hit me.
Yep, and I called the police, so any minute now you can explain to them what you thought you were doing. I don't want to hear it.
There was a momentary pause. Then Gareth said sulkily and still into the rug.
This always happens.
You've done this before.
My tone was as icy as the wind currently flipping at the letterbox.
I'm too nice, that's my trouble. Too easy to say no to. But you had tea with me, chatted, reckoned I'd be in with a shout. Thought you might be up for a friends with benefits thing, you know. Something casual, just to take you out of yourself, sort of thing.